Welcome to Strength of Materials. This video is related to numerical on compound stresses using Mohr circle. So in this video we will be seeing a numerical. So this is a numerical question. An element cube is subjected to tensile stress of 30 Newton per mm square and 10 Newton per mm square acting on mutually perpendicular planes and shear stresses of 10 Newton per mm square on these planes. Draw the Mohr circle of stresses and the hence or otherwise determine the magnitudes and directions of the principal stresses and also the greatest shear stress. So the question is here, let us draw the figure. So given data, major principal stress sigma 1 is 30 Newton per mm square, sigma 2 is 10 Newton per mm square, tau equal to 10 Newton per mm square. Mohr circle method, let us fix the scale as 1 centimeter equals to 10 Newton per mm square for drawing of Mohr circle. This the part Mohr circle method, let us fix the scale. After the scale, sigma 1 is taken in terms of scale of 15 centimeters. The scale, now we are changing it 1 centimeter to 2 Newton per mm square. So earlier the scale we have decided we need to change it, then we are changing it to 2 Newton per mm square. In that way sigma 2 is 10 divided by 2, 5 centimeters, and sigma tau equal to 10 divided by 2, 5 centimeters. So let us begin to draw the Mohr circle. Mark one vertical line and one horizontal line. Then mark the starting point as A, end point of horizontal line as M. Then we have to mark the particular C point, such as it is the sigma 2 value 10 Newton per mm square, which is equals to 5 centimeters. Then we need to mark the sigma 1 value as 30 Newton per mm square, 15 centimeters, as B point. Then shear stress, we have to draw the shear stress perpendicular at C point and B point. C point, this is the shear stress of 10 Newton per mm square perpendicular to C point, 5 centimeters. Similarly at B point in the downward direction, that is anti-clockwise clockwise rotation, 10 Newton per mm square, 5 centimeters. Now we need to join these two as a points. So let us mark this as a diagonal line as the shear stress diagonals. So these points are G and F at the end. So there will be a perpendicular line CG and BF, then the central point as O. Now marking this, we got the radius of OG and OF. We are marking the Mohr circle on this particular two points. So here is the Mohr circle drawn with the center as O to G and O to F as the radius. Now from this O and horizontal line, diagonal GF line, we have to mark the angle 2 times theta. So this is the 2 times theta angle. Now we will mark the part as AL and this line as the one of the particular stress which we are going to find. Then one more line as A to end circle, that as AN, as another stress which is required. One is major stress, one is minor principal stress. Then OH will be the maximum shear stress, whatever we wanted it, which from the center. So let us know what are the particular stress values which we have taken from the Mohr circle. Again we need to convert them into the scale part. So converting them to the scale part, we got the values as AN is equals to 17.1 centimeter, AL is equals to 2.93 centimeters, and OH is equals to 7.05 centimeter, which is the radius of Mohr's circle. So now angle of FOB or 2 theta, it is 45 degrees. Make a correction, it is not 450, it is 45 degrees. So, my major principal stress is length of AN into scale, that is 17.2 multiplied by 2, 34.2 Newton per mm square. Then minor principal stress, length of AL into scale, that is 2.93 into 2, 5.86 Newton per mm square. Similarly, location of principal planes is 2 theta, which is 45 degrees. Therefore, theta is equals to 45 degrees divided by 2, 22.5 degrees. Then the second principle is given by 90 plus 22.5, which is equals to 112.5 degrees. It is 112.5 degrees. Then the greatest shear stress is equals to length of OH into scale, which is equals to 7.05 into 2 is equals to 14.1 Newton per mm square. So this was the first problem of Mohr circle, which is solved in this video. Let us go for next numerical. In this numerical, we have the question as the principal stresses at a point in a bar are 160 Newton per mm square, that is tensile, and 80 Newton per mm square as compressive. Determine the resultant stress in magnitude and direction on a plane inclined at 60 degrees to the axis of major principal stress. Also determine the maximum tensile of shear stress, intensity of shear stress in the material at the point. Now the part is with the numerical part. Let us draw the figure for the particular question. So this is the major stress is 160 Newton per mm square acting as the tension and 80 Newton per mm square acting as the compression. So this 60 degree is inclined at a major principal plane stress. So this is the 60 degrees, major principal plane is this one. So to this 60 degrees angle is acting. So now let us mark with the Mohr circle. Solution: major principal plane sigma 1, 160 Newton per mm square. Minor principal stress sigma 2, minus 80 Newton per mm square. So one is positive, one more is negative value. Mohr circle method, again taking the scale as 1 centimeter is equals to 10 Newton per mm square. Going with the drawing, so vertical line is drawn, horizontal line is also drawn with a mark of A at the junction of vertical and horizontal joints. Then marking at the end of the right side M point. C point is the and B point is the. So these are the particular values of 160 Newton per mm square, 16 centimeter is at C point, 80 Newton per mm square is at 8 centimeter. So now let us mark this O point as the center of B and C. So O is center of B and C. So now we are drawing the diagonal, that is the 60 degree shear stress plane on the center. And now we have this as N point, which will be the radius of the particular Mohr circle. So this arrow is particularly the radius. The radius is O to C or O to B. Now this radius we are drawing as the particular value of the Mohr circle. Now we are marking A to J as where the particular plane is going to have the cutting of this particular N point on the plane. This vertical will be the AJ, that is the 10 centimeters, and JN is 10.39 centimeters, the vertical and the horizontal. Now the resultant of this is the particular maximum shear stress is O to this point. And AN is the resultant value, which is having an angle of 5 degrees, phi, that is the particular Mohr circle. Now this is the resultant stress, 14.42 centimeters. Moving further for the calculation of the values with respect to the scales, AJ mentioned as 10 centimeters, length of JN mentioned as 10.39 centimeters, and length of AN 14.42 centimeter, the resultant stress. Normal stress sigma is equals to length of AJ into scale, which is 10 into 10, 100 Newton per mm square, and shear stress sigma, that is length of JN into scale, 10.39 into 103.42 9, which will be the particular 103.9 Newton per mm square. Now let us measure and calculate the values. Now by measuring the particular values of length AJ is equals to 10 centimeters, length of JN is equals to 10.39 centimeters, length of AN is equals to 14.42 centimeters. And therefore normal stress sigma is equals to length AJ into scale, that is 10 into 10 Newton per 100 Newton per mm square. Shear stress tau is equals to length JN into scale, that is 10.39 into 10 is equals to 103.9 Newton per mm square. Angle phi is equals to 46 degrees. Resultant stress sigma r length of AN is into scale. So 14.42 into 10, 144.2 Newton per mm square. Then maximum shear stress is equals to radius of Mohr circle, that is sigma 1 plus sigma 2 divided by 2, which is this is sigma 1 minus sigma 2 by 2. There is the minus sign we have used and converted it into plus. So sigma 1 minus sigma 2 divided by 2 will give us the resultant. So 160 plus 80 divided by 2, 240 divided by 2, that is 120 Newton per mm square is the radius of particular Mohr circle. Thank you. See you in the next video.